Hello and welcome to your favorite newscast, The Hornet Report. I'm Carlee Brew, and sitting alongside me today is my partner in crime, Faith Wareham. Faith, can you believe it's already time for spring break? It feels like just yesterday we were taking advantage of all of those early January snow days, and now it's almost time to go to the beach.
I know, Carlee, it's just crazy. But to be honest, I trade all of our snow days for just one day at the beach. So close, yet so far. Senioritis might be hitting us a little hard right now, but that warm weather and that post-AP serotonin boost is right around the corner.
You got that right. Time really is flying by. Speaking of heading into new things, why don't you tell us the news stories for this week?
Of course, Carlee. First up, traveling from the TV studio and onto the basketball court, the 3-on-3 basketball tournament hosted by yours truly, the TV and Film Society, was held in March and raised a huge fund for Alex's lemonade stand. Next, for the first time in 2 years, all language honor societies held an international dinner on April 7th. And to round out today's episode, the Holmdel District Concert was also performed in person. It's so great to see all of these important events taking place once again in person. With that said, let's make our way to the courts for the 3-on-3 basketball tournament.
What would you say was your favorite part about tonight's game?
Our Coach Blake, and us as a team, the Jumping Jacksons.
How does it feel like to win?
Look, man, it's unbelievable. I just want to thank my friends and family back at home. I'm so happy. Like, all the work.
It's all right, buddy. It's all right.
Sorry.
Make some noise for the winning team.
All right, Nick, can you tell us what your team name is?
We are the Flint Tropics.
Are you having a lot of fun tonight with this?
I'm having a blast tonight. I'm having a great time.
What would you say is your favorite part of this, of tonight, like playing and all that?
100% playing basketball is my favorite part. Winning definitely. You want them to speak here?
Yeah, it's really nice atmosphere out here. A lot of wins, a lot of shots knocked down. Great time.
Organized too, extremely organized. We're doing great down here.
I like the rain. It's really cooling me off, honestly.
Yep.
It's really feeling great.
We're doing awesome.
Ball movement's incredible. Ball movement's incredible.
I'm loving this.
We're loving it.
All right, I got Tom Sardo here. Tom, why don't you tell us, how does it feel to be the champions of the 3-on-3 hoops event this evening?
It feels pretty good. Like I said in the beginning, you know, we were going to come in here and take the trophy home, and that's exactly what we did. We all played amazing, and we got the win for Max. We got Vito over here. He's the top shooter in the conference right now. Cheeseburger, you don't want to get in his way. He'll knock you over. And then Max, who's a pure lock on defense. And at the end of the day, I'm just going to go home and sleep well because we're the champs. That's all. You want to say
anything, Max? Let's go home, though. We're the champs.
Yeah! Wow, I still can't believe we were able to raise almost $8,000 for Alex's lemonade stand. The entire Holmdel community really stepped up and rallied together to fight childhood cancer. Thank you to everyone who donated and participated in the 3-on-3. In other news, the Language Honor Society hosted their first World Language Dinner in 2 years. It was a wonderful night filled with dancing, singing, and lots of food. I was able to be there myself with the Spanish Honor Society, and everyone had a great time. Vamos a mirar la historia de la cena internacional.
Ciao, mi chiamo Fede, and welcome to the International Dinner hosted by all of the Language Honor Societies. You know, I know it's been a couple years since we've been able to host this event. I know I'm excited to be back, and I hope you are too. Let's get right into it. Who do you think brought the best food game tonight?
Hey, definitely the Italian Honor Society!
China Internazionale!
Hey!
I think, personally, the Chinese Honor Society, because they brought props and they have a video on screen.
So as the president of the Italian Honor Society, how do you feel about tonight? What do you think is most successful?
I think tonight's a great night to demonstrate the diversity we have here with our language program, all the different cultures that will be represented and their dance performance and all the great food we have. So it's great to be able to learn a little bit about all the other cultures and also just connect more with those within your own society.
Grazie mille. Quello era molto fantastico. In my opinion, the Italian Honor Society did quite a spectacular job with their presentation, food, and desserts. But all the different cuisines and showcases were awesome to see, and I definitely appreciate the diversity here at HHS. Next up, the Holmdel District Concert last week was an amazing presentation of all the instrumental talent here at HHS. Ryan Lopez caught it all on camera.
I was in the district concert. I was actually playing for the high school band on trumpet, basically.
And Lucian, how did you feel being up there? Did you feel like any big experiences being playing for everybody?
I'm gonna be honest, it was just really stressful, especially because I just started the trumpet. But I especially could see this song is like, it starts out like intense, so like it's really easy to mess up. So.
Tonight's concert was the jazz ensemble. I thought the music was really interesting, really fun, and I just really enjoyed their performance. I thought it was really, really good.
Part about the district concert is that the young ones can see the old ones perform and be inspired to grow and improve their instrument or their voice, and it's just really great to have all of them perform for each other and see how we've grown throughout the years in our music making. So it's such a pleasure to watch and hear the talented musicians here in Holmdel.
Wow, that concert really blew me away. It's crazy how many talented musicians we have here in Holmdel. I know, right? Very impressive. Wait, Carlee, do you know where Ben is? You were supposed to watch after him today. Dang it, I completely forgot. He must still be waiting to give us the sports update. Quick, switch to Ben.
Finally, I thought you guys forgot about me. In sports news, the softball team won their first game 12-6 against Ocean Township. The boys' golf team won their match against Mater Dei, while the girls also won over Red Bank Catholic. In other sports news, the boys' lacrosse team has a winning record of 3-2 after wins over Brick Township, SJV, and Brick Memorial. The girls' team won their most recent game against Marlboro 7-3. The boys' tennis team has a winning record with their victories over Monmouth Regional and Raritan. Congratulations to the boys' volleyball team, who recently earned their first win in program history over Red Bank Catholic. And in track and field, Daniel Vesley threw 128 feet and 3 inches in the discus to take second place at the recent meet. And Julia Saporito also finished second in the girls' discus after recording the second best throw of all time at Holmdel High School with 107 feet and 4 inches. Way to go, Hornets. Keep up the great work. I'm Ben Sammut, and that's the buzz on Holmdel Sports.
Oh, thank gosh he's safe and healthy, and with so much sports news to report. To make sure not to miss any more sports news, or any news at all, be sure to follow us on social media.
Our Twitter and Instagram are at HHS Hornet Report, and our Snapchat is at Hornet Report.
Thank you, and join us next time, where we'll bring you this week's best at HHS.